believe the last place we left off was the mines. So, let's continue. Alright, come on. Load up, please. Thank you. Load time's a killer, man. So yeah, I killed a bunch of these pieces of shit. Did I just break it? Yeah, clear my throat. Let me clear my throat. Hope you don't mind. Let me clear my throat. Is there anything over here worth me teleporting and shit? Does not look like it. What? Is a shrieker? Oh, wow. I believe here we go. She has the wand. Ha I thought they'd be.
Whoa, what was that? Those magisters are about to become
come on. Another one. Scooting. Maybe I can switch the wand real quick. things keep flying around, I can't really do much. Son of a bitch. Can't do shit. Do the barrage on him. Hello, person that's not watching me. Welcome to the stream. Grab a seat.
His blooded face with a grimy rag as he strides towards you. Eyes narrowing with suspicion, he halts several feet away, one hand on the hilt of his weapon.
And you are? Good thing I didn't bother cleaning my blade yet.
Oh, he's really gonna fight us after all that? I don't know why he's talking to fucking Loesch. I'm the persuasion guy. Whatever. Yeah, so there's a few options we got here. I kind of want to get rid of this guy. Only because he's right in front of these mages of ours, and we can't have him fucking that up for us. So, let's take a shot. I think I'm gonna just come over here, deal with this guy, make them push, and deal with them as they come. Cobra. No. I need to kill this guy. Master Grimori. You're pissing me off, Grimori. Actually, we could leave this to the prince. Oh, fuck, we can't tactical retreat. Kind of whack. The 3 turns. Yeah, I might as well stay where I'm at and do the shots on this guy. It's gonna be his turn afterwards. Yeah, let's do the shot on him. It's fine. Why am I fucking moving? Shoot. Yes. And I miss. He's not moving for some strange reason. I figured he'd be eager to chase us, but apparently not. I'm gonna move towards the ladder just enough so I can hit this guy. He's gonna be coming up through the ladder. So this guy is really on my dick right now. Like, holy shit. Can you fuck off? He's good. He's not gonna move, so we're just gonna hit this guy again. Since you're standing here like a dumb fuck, and you haven't moved, and you picked a fight with us. Loish, I guess you can start trying to hit that guy. Hit him from here. Cool beans. This guy's a little pain in the ass. And I fucking missed. It's because of the smoke, I know, but still. Still can't fucking hit this jerk off. I can't hit myself. Alright, cool, whatever. He's really not gonna move at all.
Incredible discovery.
Can I hit him? The fuck? This game could be real wonky sometimes. Land here, it might be too far, but we'll see. It's the worst thing. Is it? Can I have him? Are you fucking kidding me? This game is really fucking annoying me right now. There's no way down from here that doesn't involve me getting hit. Can you fucking move? What the hell is this? This guy's just humming and shit. What is this game right now? Holy shit. Prince, can you Phoenix dive? Right. seems like the most appropriate position. Fane, I need you to teleport someone over there. Teleport this guy somewhere, not there. Cool. That's what I want. This thing is pissing me the fuck off. Let's teleport him right here. I'll yield to none. Just enough distance. So let's hit him with the 1-2, buckle my shoe. Like this. Let's also hit him with the, you still got armor? Yeah, but we could pin him. Before I do that. The fucking hell, bro, what the? 68%. Quick save it. Did I quick save it? All right, here we go.
The pedestal seems empty, as if it once supported something, something powerful. You surmise that this was once the resting place of the Aetheron, until it was torn free and borne away. If this is what Dallas was looking for, then she has claimed her prize.
This must be where the Magisters found the Aetheron.
Over there, on the tables. Those are my people's tablets.
You gotta do something here, poison bottle.
Rubbish.
Rubbish. You don't want that? That's healing.
Rubbish.
Tablet. I feel like Fiend would be the best one for this, but we will see.
The tablet is marked on all sides with eternal runic inscriptions, but they look like they were hacked into indecipherability with a chisel. As your fingertips trace these mutilated runes, your eyes flicker closed of their own accord. You see nothingness, vast, dark, and empty. You sense something ancient watching you, perusing you like a prison guard would watch a wayward ant scuttling across the floor of a cell. From within the endless emptiness, a strangely familiar voice hums into being and calls to you. Godwoken. Fane. You sense an interest within the cold voice addressing you. Beyond the interest, you sense fangs, voracious hunger, a bottomless appetite that no sustenance could ever sate. You see your life flash before your eyes, every memory flitting by like a moth's wings at a lantern. the vision reaches the present moment and diverges into multiple strands. Impossible to keep track. Your brain aches with the effort of trying to keep up with the intelligence as it sifts through your every potential future. You see salvation and destruction, and all of a sudden, it's over. Blackness rises once more, just as it was at the start. Eternal darkness and you. An electric feeling pulses in your fingertips, and a force field of some kind pushes you away from the tablet.
It's active. Even after all these years, it's still active. Now, if only I knew what the hell it was doing.
As your fingertips trace these mutilated runes, your eyes flicker closed of their own accord. You see nothingness. You sense something ancient from within. You see your brain, and all of a sudden, an electric. The tablet looks the same, but you cannot touch it. An invisible force field of some kind prevents you from touching.
Pick that shit up.
The tablet seems to glow from within with a subtle light. Etched runes cover its surface. The markings feel familiar, but you have no idea what they mean. Your fingertips burn so hot, it feels like they are melting. An energy seems to travel between the tablet and your hands, sparking knowledge directly into your mind. Electrical sensations sizzle in your mind. You understand that the runes are ancient Rivalonian, the oldest known language. You feel the fragments under your fingers. An Lesru. You know not how, but you understand the meaning of these words with the very marrow of your being. One. Then your fingers grow cold to the bone. Suddenly, you are just a person standing in a cavern, clinging to a stone tablet, as if it were...
I don't really know what these are for. I have a theory that they're somehow connected or prophesize the coming of a god walking, and that's about it. That's as far as far as I know.
The pedestal. See, if this is what Dallas.
And it's somehow as a person. Like physically affecting me, like touching it, makes you see visions and shit.
I've spotted something.
I mean, obviously, I just gotta see the thing behind it. Alright, real quick, we did get a helmet, so let's see what that does. It is better. Let's check the prince's armor. Hmm. a 2 points extra. This is probably the better armor still. Did get some weapons as well. Or one weapon. I'll keep the one I got. Climbable rock, slidable door.
I've never seen anything like this workmanship.
Click saving again.
The stone relic pulls on your consciousness. You feel the tendrils of an ancient hunger trespassing within your soul, seeking something, something you have. Source. You stare at the artifact in amazement. Even though it's broken and suffering from centuries of neglect, there's no mistaking it for what it is. Eternal technology.
Eternals are still alive, kinda.
There's a body.
Gotta teleport me out of me. Don't mind if I do. Teleporting myself. Hey, baby. Back with the Scooby-Doo gang. I did get a key, maybe not. Eternal technology.
The stone relic pulls on your consciousness. You stare at the artifact in amazement. Even though it's broken and suffering from centuries of neglect, there's no mistaking it for what it is. Eternal technology.
I feel like touching it is gonna suck, but Fane is not touching it. And if Fane's not touching it, a bit of a problem here. I feel like it's gonna kill me touching it.
The stone relic pulls on your consciousness. You feel the tendrils of an ancient hunger. As your fingertips brush the cool stone, you feel the depths of your being crack open. Your power flows from you into the relic, yet a reverse current flows back into you with a new power, a different power. A sharp electrical shock repels your hands from the stone and sends you staggering backwards.
A recipe to craft Mask of the Shapeshifter? Well, that's disappointing.
That's what I got? I already have that. Wow. Well, dude, that a rat? That's a rat running down around there. Okay. So yeah, let me use this ghost vision shit. There's one ghost.
The spirit's memory, in its madness, you are a sensate, deaf and mute, but gifted with an unnatural ability. Dallas seeks you out and brings you here into the darkness. When the blindfold falls, Dallas bids you find and free a secret power. You close your eyes, and you feel the presence of a hidden truth. You point at it and open your eyes. You are pointing at Dallas. The hammer calmly bids you try again, then steps back. You close your eyes once more. Now the vault before you sings to you. You raise your hand to it. It opens to your touch. From the vault, you take a sword. It's weightless, yet it feels more powerful even than Dallas herself, and yet fragile. A hand falls upon your shoulder. A blade crosses your throat. Blood pours. Dallas whispers, "Good girl," and then all goes quickly dark.
So she betrayed whoever helped her out here. Cool. That's it in terms of ghosts and shit, so let's get out of here. Let's get out of here, guys. We could read this guy's thing to find out.
Folding his arms across his chest, the Magister stares at you with
blankful eyes. Apparently, send the artifact away.
One by one, he points at the dead Voidwoken, the dead Magisters, the dead Silent Watchers. Then he points at you.
Your end comes, sorcerer, just as it came for them. And for me. Friedemann guided the excavation rightly. Soon, Dallas will use the Aetherian on you. And then you will be the sorcerer. No.
He says nothing, only twists his lip bitterly as he echoes, pointing at the dead. Pointing at the dead, then.
Okay. The Aetherian is going to be used on... shut up. What's wrong with these fucking people? They talk a lot, right? They talk so much. I know that's like 50% of the game, or more like 75, but... my god, do they talk.
Magisters. Up to no good, no doubt.
Black Wing Magister. The fuck is that? Oh, that's that abomination.
What word on getting this oil contraption working again? We need more barrels to bring down this blasted wall.
Nothing yet, madam. The Black Ring captive you executed was the only one who knew how to operate it.
He was a saboteur and paid the price.
So basically, the Magisters made these monk-looking things, which are just people, but like, whipped and trained and brainwashed into this shit. It's pretty crazy, right? I mean, there's no doubt about it, these motherfuckers are evil. Evil fucking people.
Nothing yet, madam.
Wait. The fuck? Fane. Prince, you're just gonna hold the ladder for now. You're gonna burn to death, my guy. Back there, apparently you can shoot through some boxes, whatever. Normal bullshit in this game, as per usual. Now this chick seems to be a problem.
How much of this shit is wet? It's a good question. Decisions. Alright, we need to get rid of these dogs ASAP. That's obviously something we gotta do.
Glory is mine.
Especially when we got all these problems. There's some magic armor, some garbo. that again. Let's keep the advantage on these guys down here by shocking and freezing them. As long as we keep them out of the fight, it's those people we have to worry about. It worked. Alright, cool. And whoever's the least. Let's shoot this guy. Fucking missed, come on. She kind of wasted her turn. I'm not sure I would have done that, but she never swapped me with someone. Yeah, this guy, he's dead. Yeah, I'm not sure I would have done that, but I am not the AI. Let's do this move. And let's kill this guy. And is the weapon some trouble? No. He's good. He's alright. This dog's a bit of a problem though. We could do reactive shot and probably hit them. I don't like that probably. So let's do all three. Yeah, it was a good idea not doing reactive on that. Fane, we got a bit of a problem here, Fane. And you might be the one and only man to solve it. She wasn't in that shit. Thank you.
frozen, right? Yeah, she's frozen. And we're going to... These dogs are a pain in the toto. We're going to fortify, not fortify, shields up, and hit this fucking cunt. Hit him. Oh my god, bro, this shit pisses me off sometimes. He slipped, cool.
You're not trying to escape, are you?
Hit him, cool. He's probably gonna hit Fane. No, he's gonna hit the prince, but the prince has got a shield up. I am going to shoot this guy. I mean, the target's too far. I'm a fucking archer. How is this 68%? He's on fire. You know what? Asking the wrong questions. And I missed twice. This fucking game, bro. Anyway, I'm gonna move back. First day down here, yourself? Cool. You're a little bitch. She healed him a little bit. Cool. Fane. Could probably kill a few people here. So, you need to kill this guy. He's got it. She's gotta go. He's gotta go. Resisted by magic line. Didn't realize she got magic line back. It has to end my turn. Interrupted myself. I am going to shoot this fucking guy. Yeah, it's just you now, you silly bitch. What you gonna do? I'll tell you what you're gonna do. You're gonna take a fucking nap. Fane, do you have your water spell up? No, you don't. She isn't chilled at all. To her at this point. Prince, you should go down there. Thank you.
to none.
What a crazy spell. That's that. Magister's cloak. I feel like that could be pretty dope, so we're going to take a look at this fucking thing. And they're in desperate need of an upgrade. Ooh, and magic defense is a little ridiculous. Whoa, put the cloak on.
Impressive. A barrel filling machine for the oil, I believe.
How is that impressive? A machine that fills barrels of oil. You're just talking right now, Fane.
Guess I know what I need to do now.
We do? I didn't really read that book. The only thing that will save my life is knowledge that those order puppets don't have yet. At least I hope so. Machine restore sequence. Ember, Sapphire, Emerald. Ember, Sapphire, Emerald.
From somewhere deep within the inner workings of the machine comes an irregular clanking sound, then a weak gurgle. There is a sudden shh.
Just break it. Come on, I gotta reload now. Ember's orange or red? It might be orange.
Thank you.
It was Ember.
Deep within the inner workings of the machine comes an irregular clanking sound, then a weak gurgle.
Guess it could be
inoperable, it seems. The machine churns into life. Gears rotate and pistons hiss from somewhere within its metal housing. It settles into a slow metallic chug. Ready for the machine churns into life. It settles into a slow... The machine churns into life. The machine rattles, grinds, and hisses for a protracted moment, but then settles down into a steady mechanical thrum, functional by the sound of it.
It's working.
All right, cool. We fixed it. Ember is yellow. Figured it'd be red or orange, but never yellow. Where's the fucking barrels I just picked up? Am I bugging or they're not in here? Definitely not bugging, because they're not in here. Anywho, we're just gonna drop those barrels.
Barrels. Not a careful excavation, it seems.
Cool. It's open. Let's go.
I've seen places like this in books. Never thought I would see something like this in reality.
It's
hard to say whether it's magical or mechanical or both. You can probably put this thing to good use somehow. Send it to the prince.
This is the archaeological discovery of a lifetime.
The curious sculpture comes alive as you reach out to touch it. It thrums with power and throws flickering, dancing shadows against the wall. The carving is covered in strange glyphs that feel oddly familiar. They surround a gently glowing stone that makes you think of the night sky rolled into a ball.
Does Thane have a better understanding of this shit? Because this is his people's shit, so...
The curious sculpt, the carving is covered in eternal... You read, our first lord's babes with power glowed hoed. Our third's young to the wind return. Our fourth's to glowing flames adjourn. Our fifth lord's cubs with minds were blessed. Our sixth's had brawn beyond the rest. Our seventh's brood spread from earth to glen, and thus no king shall rise again. You step away from the pillar, your mind racing.
No king shall rise again? What happened here?
The sculpture is covered in eternal. Something shifts within the sculpture, and you're knocked back by a sudden burst of energy. The glow from the columns...
Ralek, I used to pray to you when I was young.
Ah, Lady Santedza. You were the only one of the seven that could take a joke. Lord Vrogir, a champion of martial challenges, less so of mental challenges.
It's Amadia. Mother of wizards.
Blessed Zolcissa, an elegant god for our elegant people.
Duna, the stoutest of the seven. No wonder the dwarves pray to him. Ah, tears and death. Well, that wasn't right. Worshipped by my people. Strange. I've never seen anything like this before.
Stop.
Stoutest of the seven.
Blessed Zolcissa.
No wonder the dwarves pray to
him. An elegant god for our elegant people.
It's Amadia, the mother of wizards.
Yo, it really pisses me off when you fucking... You see that? It's locking onto that, so if I press X, he'll run to it. And I can't move the fucking stick away from you. I have to press circle to stop.
Santedza, the goddess of mirth.
I used to pray to you when I was young.
That wasn't right.
The sculpture is covered in strip trying to read the symbols. You hear a faint whispering at the back of your mind. Your mind swims, and for you read, our first lord's babes with power glowed, our seconds born in blood that flowed. Our third's young to the wind return, our fourth's to glowing flames adjourn. Our fifth lord's cubs with minds were blessed, our sixth's had brawn beyond the rest. Our seventh's brood spread from earth to glen, and thus no king shall rise again. You try to hold your focus as the whispering echo fades, but the letters waver, contorting and merging until they're nothing but meaningless glyphs.
At least we know what the sixth one is.
The sculpture is trying to read the symbol. Your mind swim. You read, our first lord's babes with power glowed, our seconds born in blood that flowed. our thirds young glowed. To the wind return, our fourths to glowing flames adjourn. Our fifth lord's cubs with minds were blessed, our sixths had brawn beyond the rest. Our seventh's brood spread from up. You try to hold.
Power glow is the first one, so let's get that out of the way.
Ralek, I used to pray to you when I was young.
Xantetze, the goddess of mirth, worshipped by imps. The god of the orcs, Vrogir.
I'm looking this shit up. I'm not fucking doing this. Nameless statue, divinity, judo. Hate this fucking thing, bro.
The stoutest of the
blessed
seven.
Zorlsis.
No wonder the dwarves
an
prayed.
An elegant god for our elegant people.
It's Amadia. The mud. Well, that wasn't right.
Alright, the first one is Anna. First one right here.
It's Amadia, the mother of wizards.
And Tyr.
Tyr Sandelius, worshipped by my people.
Duna. Come on.
Duna, the stoutest of the seven. No wonder the dwarves pray to
him. An elegant god for our elegant people.
Zoril. Where the fuck is Zoril?
Xantetze, the god of the orcs, Vrogir.
Ralek, I used to pray to you when I was young.
That's it. We're through.
Perfect. Stupid puzzle.
What in the name of Lucian's prize pig is going on here? I wonder what they did in life to deserve such a resting place.
As the creature crawls from the sarcophagus, you hear a gasp of breath. Fane steps forward, never taking his eyes off her.
I must speak to her. It is vital. Please, stand aside.
You hear a gasp from the creature as Fane steps forward. It speaks in a hissing, clicking language that seems both completely alien and somewhat familiar. Fane raises his head and responds in the same jolting, clicking tongue. He seems to be pleading with the creature, his hands outstretched. The creature looks down at him and shrieks in rage. Her gestures are quick, strong, and violent. Whatever she said, it seems to have devastated your friend. The verbal barrage continues, but something changes within Fane. He looks up, and golden light pours from his skull. When he speaks next, you understand every word, but you're not sure the words are his own.
Aetira, Aetira. I had hoped to see you turn to dust in this tomb. Alone, forgotten, with only your secrets for comfort.
Lady Amadia? You possess him. Have you fallen so far that you seek shelter within that? Does your vessel even know what you did? The war you started? The greed and avarice that saw you betray the Eternals?
Does your vessel even know what you did?
The glow fades, and Fane seems to return to himself. He staggers slightly, exhausted by everything that's happened. The creature turns away from him, and panting, turns to you. The creature looks down from its perch, trembling. It crawled out of that sarcophagus as if it had forgotten how to move its limbs. It turns to you, and you see its face is covered by an intricate mask. From behind its unmoving lips, you hear a noise. It starts as a groaning, croaking chatter, but slowly becomes more distinct. It's speaking.
Hey, Saravel, te de la Rontu, Shemery.
The stream of noise cuts off abruptly. After a moment, you hear a jolting, lurching voice.
It wears the face of Zol Stissa, but how cruel. I suspected the Seven Lords won the war after they locked me here, but seeing their faces on dumb creatures, a depressing confirmation. Fascinating. So quick to anger. It has the outward appearance of one of our kind. But underneath, perhaps this is to be expected when creation is left to seven amateurs. The king would never have been so sloppy in his work.
Deep within your soul, you feel your god stirring at the sound of the voice. You can feel its anger and fear swelling inside you. The creature leans forward to get a better look at you, clucking and tutting under her breath.
It seems to be a simple form at its core, a source vat. A walking, unfortunately talking, source vat. Fascinating. I wonder how to extract the source from the vessel without...
She pulls back suddenly, recoiling in horror.
It is rotting. Almost imperceptibly, but it decays before my eyes. It must have no more than a century or two left.
The god within you reacts. Her emotions a cocktail of fury and fear. You hear her voice, demanding that you give her control, demanding your body obey her will.
Terror you were. An eternity locked away was too good for you. I should have seen you ground to dust and fed to the wind. Your heresies deserve nothing less.
The figure recoils, as if struck.
Zol Stissa? What happened to you? Did you truly fall so far?
Silence. It is your king that has fallen. He and all the other Eternal cowards were flung into the void. And the power you were too scared to hunt has made me a god.
So Zol is in this guy. Amadia is in Fane. Tucendilius is inside me.
And yet here you stand, small. weak, decaying. I will not even need the Aetiran to grind you into the dust.
You feel your guard freeze at the mention of this Aetiran, a cold terror settling in your chest.
The beast's unruly passenger did not deign to tell it. She did not want her host to know. I crafted a weapon that would leave her an eternal once more.
You feel your guard thrashing against your control.
Where?
You croak in a voice not quite your own.
Ha! Of course you never found it. You always lacked imagination, my lady. I hid it in these very caves, although I can feel its distance now. Someone has uncovered it. Perhaps they intend to flay the godliness from you. No matter. Given your pathetic state, it is mine to collect at my leisure. As for you, you monstrosity, you were designed to be defective. You were built to die. And I rather think it is time you fulfilled your function. But do not fear. I shall put your source to...
Here we go. Serious? So the Eternals are gods. Doing too hot here. And you all have armor on. I can't do shit. Can't move. She's gonna freeze me again or some shit. She put oil on me. Great. She's flying away too.
Fading.
gonna die. She's gonna fucking kill me, whatever move she has. I can't do shit. Game's over. Plus, I'm supposed to die. Nope, I'm not. Waste my fucking time. So we found out a few things. One, the Eternals are the gods, or were the gods, and Atira has something to do with the extermination of the Eternals. Yeah, my dog's barking at me. Alright, so I'm gonna just grab the loot and get the fuck out of here.
What in the name of Lucian's prize pig is going on here?
I feel like I could kill her, but one, she has way too many turns. That's just ridiculous. She just robs us all of our fucking source, which is stupid. I think we're going to go to the the graveyard. Here we go.
gonna speak to Riker, see if,
The masked creature grunts three times at the sight of you. It reaches its arm out. Clasped in its hand is a crumpled parchment. You take the page, and the servant returns to its hollow existence.
Is it the other one?
The servant emits a men.
He said he'd prepared the chambers.
I've spotted something.
No. Go back up. Oh, it's just the same letter. Come on, what the fuck? Break into this room real quick. There's literally no
No keyhole, no handle. There must be a hidden mechanism.
Okay. It's probably behind one of these pictures.
This is quite the antiques collection. Keyhole. No handle. There must be a hidden mechanism.
Alright, let's go. Maybe moving this thing over to this one. Nope, did nothing.
The air buzzes with sauce here. This flesh is well past ripe. Whatever. Flesh and bone, severed and stitched. Perhaps some sort of necromancy?
this guy doing? What is this sick fuck up to?
Empty.
Look out, I see a trap nearby.
There you are, Godwoken. I'm eager to hear your good news.
Careful now, that's a trap.
I'm prepared to offer a generous reward, my dear. You're dying to show off those smoldering talents of yours. You just don't... I can help you with that. I can share my bond with the source with you, fill your well to the brim, make you a master. You do your part, then I do mine. How marvelous.
Riker's lips tremble impatiently as his eyes dart to your pack.
Show it to me.
He considers you for a...
Very well.
Riker closes his eyes and spreads his arms, then begins to recite a vivid incantation.
I call to the souls of the dead. Your remains, the stone garden's eternal burden, descend from the hall. Surrender your source to the vessel before me.
Souls. Souls undead, your remains.
Riker ignores you and continues his call. His voice grows even louder, until his words echo from every crevice in the...
Swan and Rince, Crossley and Locke, Quincy, Keller, Harkwood, Aran, an essence your cross to the void, so that she...
The words wrap themselves around you, then slip through your pores. You feel as if you could skate upon water or leap among the clouds. You are no longer less, but more.
Your well overflows, Godwoken. But I will stay as true to my word as I can. Accept this gift from the spirits of the Stone Garden in lieu of the mastery you already possess, and thus I can no longer offer. Now that you mention it, there is one other promise I need to keep.
This is gonna be a fight. Alright, so I guess it doesn't really matter which one between these. I think I would take...
A shame it has to be this way. I was just...
Yeah, I knew it. Glitter dust. Okay, we dealing with an incredibly intelligent asshole here. Doesn't mean he can't die.
Able to hit me, but I can't hit him. No, I can't. Never mind.
kill Riker in this. He dropped the hold of all these guys. Let me see something. Explosive. Fucked up, bud. No fucking way. Okay. Well, at least he's not a fucking, Yo, I thought he was an Eternal, bro. The fuck, are they all undead? Position sucks ass. Something. What a bitch. They're fucking undead. Wow. Well, this thing is completely fucking useless. Other than to draw fire, so... Yeah, you go ahead.
there, buddy.
Christ. This guy really wants my ass. You ain't gonna get it though, bud. You ain't gonna get it. Yep, there it is. Stun them fucking assholes. However, I'm not doing so hot here. Alright, so we got options. Hmm. We don't want this guy moving anymore. So stop him. I'm pretty fucked here.
Do I have any fortification potions? Telekinesis. What a bitch. Can't go over there now. Fucking fell? Wow, Prince, just wow. Let's just freeze this bitch here. Oh, you didn't freeze anything. What's going on with you, buddy? Supernova. You get three of them. You fuck, hit low shark, I know you're gonna teleport with this. Okay. Not really sure if that was a good idea, man. Jesus Christ, man. Coming. I'm keeping her alive, trying to. Prince. Even these guys are a problem. They're clearly looking for them. Which is pretty fucked here. Can I, she's got a skill. She's got a few skills, but she has a particular skill. Well, I never put combustion on. Same causing enemies in the air to go mad. Oh man, I'm not doing too well here. Stop. What is this? Magic armor? Gotta do something here. These things keep coming, oh my god. Not wet. Let's throw some water at his ass. somewhere near. I have water. There we go. Fucking killed them. Hello, stay alive. Christ. Right, I need to rest myself. What a bitch. This guy was a real pain in the ass. Where's my buddy? Kill a ton of these little fuckers. They were really on fucking Loesch, like holy shit. They were on me too, but I mean they were really, like she stood alive because of her skills. His desk key. What's up? Bullshit. Hang on, I gotta take a piss, guys. Please like and subscribe, I'll be right back, gotta take a piss. I'm back. Took a piss, got a quick snack. Right. Where's Loesch? It's way down. He cannot move because he has too much stuff. I'll send a lot of it over to the prince. Some gloves, some of that. Send it over to the prince. Which that's so much better. Now the prince is even beefier than before. Wow. 670 magic armor. Where the fuck is my body? Why can't I res myself? Can't reach my body for some reason. Grasp of the star.
Fine. This is quite the antiques collection.
You see yourself in the mirror. It's quite a sight.
Where's my body, man? Come on. Oh, this is my body? I'm so confused. My ghost is over here. Here. I feel it's not really safe anywhere around here. Anywhere in this game. Because it seems like every bit of source interaction we have with these people, these source masters, leads to me killing them. Or them killing a bunch of people. It feels like Full Metal Alchemist in terms of like the exchange of power. It's all due to like sacrificing life and doing fucked up shit. And it doesn't feel good. It doesn't feel good at all. And I'm not really sure. Oh, this has got to go to Fane. I think I just saw a ring for like 56. Yeah. Jonathan's ring. You know who really needs some shit? Oh, she has a lot actually. She's the most magic on my ever. Yeah.
Empty.
Sorry about that.
keyhole. No keyhole. No handle. There must be a hidden mechanism. This is quite the antiques collection. This is quite the antiques collection.
Figure out how to get in this room. I'm not really sure.
You see yourself in the mirror. It's quite a sight.
This is quite the antiques collection.
Empty.
I'm trying to find that supposedly hidden mechanism. My guy's not even picking anything up though. Cause this guy's got wits. He's able to figure shit out pretty easily, but he's not even recognizing anything. Maybe I have to put something on like this as well. Didn't seem to work. There's nothing behind the paintings. Let me check the ghost vision. Can I move this artifact? No. Speak to him.
The spirit's lips curl into a sneer.
Don't look so pleased with yourself. You're too quick to act. Too green still. Your bond with the source may be strengthened, but you are hard. I've nothing left to show you, and nothing left to say. Take what you must, but my remaining memories and masteries, they are mine.
His sneer is now a gash, wide and gruesome. You can barely believe one spirit could harbor so much contempt. His face only contorts further, a testament to his unmitigated contempt. Riker's killer stare never wavers. He has an eternity to wait. You do not. Your skin tingles and your joints ache, but soon tendrils of sore snake from you into him and from him into you. Your mind leaps from one of Riker's memories to the next. You struggle to control the visions as they rush past your inner eye, faster than you. Some sights manage to stand out in this temporal kaleidoscope. A dagger, a spirit. The graveyard. You look down at your mangled hand, then towards a shimmering spirit standing ahead. A feast awaits. Your efforts are useless. Your hold on Riker's spirit has weakened, and a final vision crashes into view. You slip on your spectacles and hold the parchment to your eyes. As the script comes into focus, you see the words Black Ring near the bottom, and you are thrust into the reality to become fully...
There is but one promise I have ever regretted making. One deal I have ever sought to break. That tablet, the template to the Sworn Breaker. It was the key to my freedom. Alas, I remain sworn. Yet, I take some comfort in knowing that the Black Ring comes for you, Godwoken. The lone wolves will collect on their contract.
You couldn't imagine it possible, but the spirit's scorn only grows. Riker may be silent, but his feelings are hardly secret. The spirits...
Why is he so mad with me?
The spirit grimaced.
What did I do? I kind of want to do a quick load, see if I could get him to give up how to get into that room. Okay, let's try and talk to him again. Our old buddy Riker.
Don't look so pleased with yourself. You're too quick to act, too green still. I've nothing left to show.
His sneer is now a gash, wide and gruesome. You can barely believe his face only contorts further, a testament to his unmitigated contempt. The more furious you are, the more stoic Riker becomes. Riker stands there, still, silent, and scornful. Your skin tingles, your mind leaps from... Some sights manage to stand out in this temporal kaleidoscope. A dagger, a spirit. Blackness. As your eyes grow accustomed to the dark, you first notice a glint on your readied dagger, then the pale skin of your mark. Your knife slides into the human's neck. Another clean kill. It is only then that you notice a pair of eyes shining in the darkness. A dog. Cowering in the corner. You smile and whistle. Here, boy. Here, boy. The vision fades, and reality draws closer. Just as you hold on Riker's, you slip on your spectacles and hold the parchment to your eyes. As the script comes into focus, you see the words Black Ring near the bottom, and you are thrust into the reality to become...
There is but one promise. Alas, I remain sworn. Yet, I take some comfort in knowing that the Black Ring comes.
You couldn't imagine it possible, but the spirit's scorn only grows. Riker may be silent, but his...
What a bitch. What a bitch. I thought it would free everybody, not kill everybody. But I stand corrected. Everybody is dead. Killing Riker only proved to be dead. They didn't give me much of a choice anyway.
The salamander's tongue flickers, tasting you on the air. And the dog appear to be.
What's up, Chief?
Chief. I'm the chief. How? Smoke from my peace pipe.
Scratching the pole does wonders for your nails. The cat and the dog stiff.
Hey, there's something by the tub. A fucking diamond? No way.
Unusual relic indeed. This is quite the antiques collection.
Maybe those runes are throughout the house. If I turn them all on, something will happen at the bottom where the door will open. I hope at least.
The dusty staircase leads to another, no matter how much. The dusty stairs straining and grunting.
Unusual relic indeed. This is quite the antiques collection.
Come on. Thank you.
This is quite the antiques collection. This is quite the antiques collection.
No, it doesn't. Hey, come back.
She hums quietly. The notes move in rhythm with her wandering eyes. The lizard pauses. And a smile crosses.
Me belongs to me. Servants belong to the hall. That's the way I like it.
Her hum returns, soft at first.
10 spans under, humans slept. 10 spans up, the dwarf.
Wow, money in that. I was not expecting that at all. Money in the house.
Hmm.
Too heavy.
This goes on a statue right here.
The headless statue looms over you. Its plinth bears the...
If it ain't Francis Philosopher, looks like you recovered from your existential crisis. I hope you find that wisdom you're looking for. If it ain't Francis Philosopher, looks like you recovered from your existential crisis. I hope you find that wisdom you're looking for. Won't be from me.
Probably no good either, so I'll just sell it. Pyrokinetic and where is this? Oh, this is the black pit. I gotta go back here anyway, so let's go do that. Mm-hmm.
can nosy around camp, but watch it. The docks are restricted. Even I. If you come back bleeding, don't.
Looks like trouble ahead. The Divine Order kind of trouble.
Divine Order kind of trouble. What does that even mean? Do they not know I just killed a bunch of people? Whatever, man.
We await you. Join us.
Fucking bitch. Shit, I can't purge no more. That's pretty long.
Thank you. Embrace me.
I don't want no one else to pass.
Those whites are hypocrites. Every last one of them.
We really need to be clean. They could still serve.
This place reeks of death. Perhaps their flesh will show me what happened. Ugh. This flesh is well...
Adam, I cannot help you with this request, despite the sum of gold that you offered. The White Magister is too heavily guarded, and I would have little opportunity to put my skills to use against him. I recommend that you leave the region before he seeks to imperil you further.
Do these three really need to be killed? They could still serve the Order well.
Silence. You shut your eyes tight. Sheer terror courses through you, cut short by a length of razor-sharp steel passing your surroundings somersault around you. You find yourself lying on your side, gazing up at the curious sight of your own decapitated body, teetering off its knee. Everything grows...
Okay, doesn't really tell us
Two White Magisters are discussing the fate of three magically bound captives. Captives clad in the dark shroud of the Black Ring. Noticing your arrival, the Magisters step back and take hold of their weapons.
You're not Magister Grimori.
Indeed. And your presence is most unwelcome. None of your business.
There you have it.
The two Magisters whistle up their source hounds and advance upon you, deadly intent.
Take them down.
No. What the fuck is this, man? These guys are like... Nah, I'm sorry. This is not happening. Yeah, I'm actually gonna go, I'm gonna go work out. I'll come back to this maybe later tonight. I don't know, maybe tomorrow. We'll see. Again, please like and subscribe
I really need some subscriptions. I got like fucking 19 subscribers and it's pitiful. I would really like some more guys so you can help me out. That'd be much appreciated. If you want to see more of this, it's also a good way of seeing more of it. I got a few videos up already on Divinity. It's not the full playthrough, mind you, but it's the full playthrough from when it started, if that makes sense. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Hope you're having a good day, and take care.